In this video, we're going to set up our player animator controller so that we can control what animation is playing via script. The first thing that we're going to do is to add the player prefab back to the hierarchy. Let's go to prefabs, select the player, and drag to the hierarchy. Next, we're going to open our player animator controller. Let's go to animations, animator controllers, and double-click player. Here, we have the animations that we created earlier, which have been added to the animator controller as states. Let's lay these out so we can see them a little more clearly. We'll move the player idle up, the player chop will be over here, and the player hit will be over here. The player idle is orange because it's the default state. So when the game starts playing, the player's idle animation is going to play. What we're going to do is set up the transitions when the player idle animation will stop playing and will transition to either the chop animation when the player attacks a wall or to the hit animation when the player is attacked by an enemy. The first thing that we're going to want to do is set up some parameters, which are going to be what we're going to use to trigger those animations from our scripts. You may need to click the parameters button to make the parameters visible, and then we'll hit the plus button and add a parameter of the type trigger. This first one is going to be called player chop. A trigger is like a Boolean, except it will immediately be reset after it's used in a transition. So it's a Boolean that's going to remain true for the frame in which it's called and then become false again. We're going to create another one called player hit. Next, we want to create some transitions between our states. Let's right-click player idle, select make transition, and drag to our player chop state. We're then going to right-click on player chop and make a transition back from player chop to player idle. This means that player idle can transition to player chop, and player chop can then transition back to player idle. We'll click on the transition from player idle to player chop to make it visible in the inspector. The transition from player idle to player chop is not going to have an exit time. We're going to uncheck has exit time. What this means is that we're not going to wait for the player idle animation to finish or to reach any certain point before we can transition to player chop. We're going to want the transition to happen abruptly from player idle to player chop, regardless of where we are in the idle animation. We're also going to open the settings and set the transition duration to 0. We're going to use a transition duration of 0 when we're working with sprite-based animation. When we're working with 3D animation, it's common that we may want to blend between animation states, but with sprite-based animation, that's not possible, so we're going to want to immediately transition from one state to another. Next, we're going to determine what is going to cause this transition to happen. In our list of conditions here, we're going to click the plus button to add a new condition which will determine when the transition will be made. A list of conditions will appear here. In this case, player chop, which is the default, is actually the condition that we want. If we wanted to change it, we could choose from the list and choose either player chop or player hit. Now, when the player chop trigger is set from our player script, we'll transition from player idle to player chop. For our transition from player chop back to player idle, here, we're going to keep has exit time active, but we're going to set it to 1, meaning that the player chop animation is going to need to be completely finished before we're going to transition back to player idle. We're also going to set the transition duration here to 0. Because we set has exit time to true from player chop to player idle, we're not going to need any additional conditions. The transition will be made when the exit time is reached. Let's set up the same things for player hit. We'll select player idle, choose make transition, and drag to player hit. We'll click on player hit, right click, choose make transition, and transition back to player idle. We'll highlight the transition from player idle to player hit, And here we're going to set hasExitTime to false because we want to interrupt the player idle animation whenever the player is hit. And we're going to set our transition duration again to 0. In our list of conditions, we're going to hit the plus button and select player hit from the dropdown. For our transition back to player idle, we're going to use hasExitTime because we want the animation to finish playing, setting exit time to 1 because we want it to transition at the end of the animation, and we're going to set the transition duration to 0. Before we move on, we can give this a quick test. Let's temporarily dock the animator window down here on the bottom of the screen, play our game, and what we'll do is we're going to manually fire the triggers and see what happens. First, we'll try player chop, and then we'll try player hit. Excellent. So we can see that those are working. Now that we've got our player animator controller working, we're going to move on in the next video to writing the player script.